Hello, everyone, and welcome to another episode of the Cardano Artist Corner. I'm one of your hosts, Brian of Guy Stakepool. Also, today we have with us your host, Alfred of Hotel Stakepool, and our guest 3D artist and teacher, Emilio Leon from La Rioja, Spain. And if you like our videos, please give this video a free thumbs up. It really helps get the video out to more people. And if you could please hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications so that you'll always know when we post a new video with the latest from the Cardano art world. Let's get started. So, first question, could you tell us a bit about you? What is your story and how did you become involved with art?
Okay, I studied fine arts. So from the beginning, I want to make a career making art or teaching art or so. In the first years, I was working blueprints in architectural study. And I took contacts with 3D applications to render architectures, and I will get in love with that kind of programs. I'm also with 3D Studio. Later, I become teacher in schools of in La Rioja, in secondary schools. And at the same time, I've been working, but as a side project, in arts. I draw, I use watercolors, I use things, I make a digital photography and this kind of stuff because I want to dominate the things that I teach. It's like to leave the things you are going to transmit to your students. And it's like a practice exercise. It's you can spend some time without running, but at the end you need it. You need to do something. It's like a necessity to draw or to paint or whatever. So it's the way to express yourself and to get out ideas or at the same time. So it's almost everything in my life.
I have one question that you don't know about, Brian. Sorry, the village where you grew up has a strange nickname, no?
Yeah, it's Aldea Nueva de Ebro. Aldea is the name is known as the Three Lights town, Three Lights village, because it's not Aldea. Aldea in Spanish is a small village, and it's not so small. It's like a town. It's the first light. This is not new because it came from medieval times at least, so it's older than, and it's not close to the River Ebro. It's for 5 kilometers far from the River Ebro, so it's the Three Lights town. So it's everything is like in the name, and it's like a way to keep it skeptical about everything, because our politics, about life, because you have to take in doubt everything before to process the ideas, because sometimes things are not like that than they look like.
Yeah, the way they seem.
So what led you to your interest in using 3D models to make your art?
Okay, I started in the 90s. I took after the university, I took a course with AutoCAD. It's an application for CAD to render things. And it was very primitive at the beginning. It runs under MC-DOS. It was very tough to work with that. The memory was not very good, but you had the capability to convert a plan in something realistic in some way. And I like this. It took me that because it's too, for me, it's to have the capability to do something real without being virtual at the same time. This, I don't know how to express, but when you hit render and you get the 3D picture, it was like, oh, our 90s, because it was very, very new. We are now used to see that kind of pictures in every place, and it's not so special. But at the beginning, I took a great interest in that. And I was starting working with an architect, drawing blueprints in plans for the buildings. And I took interest in render some of the buildings and put lights and put materials in the planes and another thing. Is to get the idea of the reality. You compare and something, the relationship between the idea, the real picture and the reality was very, very interesting for me.
I have a question for both of you, because I met more artists who were before, they were, or at the same time, they were also architects. Uh-huh. So do you think there's a connection between the two things? Are many architects artists or reverse, or is it just a coincidence?
For me, I study fine arts, painting, sculpture, not architecture at all. Right. But I studied technical drawing. I have a lot of subjects in technical drawing. So when I finished the career, the university, it was very difficult to find something in La Rioja, in Aldea Nueva de Ebro. It's a small town, 200,000, 300,000 inhabitants. So it was impossible to work making arts. So a good way to start to work, it was to work with architects. So it was by chance. But I think architects work with the space, with volume, with textures, materials, lights, and it has a lot of relationship, that kind of.
Yeah, just there's a lot more employment in the design area and architecture. So you'll find artists that if they can get those skills, then they can get a job. So,
right.
So you mentioned in your notes for the interview that your first major piece of 3D art was a piece called Deja Vu. A bit about this piece and how it influenced your work?
I was asked to participate in a collective exhibition about portrait. And it was the beginning of 3D study. I have a normal computer. So I decided to use something geometrically basic because they are like cubes. Idea of a face that changes like a Rubik cube is what I mean. So it's, for me, it was like a render, not a portrait of a concrete person, but a portrait, the idea that you have about a person that you know, but it recalls you another person. You understand? I am a teacher. I know a lot of students every year, a lot of parents. So I have, sometimes I mix the faces, and it's like in the Rubik's Cube. So I decided to do that. And the way to do the cubes, it was good because it was not too computer demanding. I had with the idea, with the result, with the working with the computer, and I decided to go further with this kind of of medium to work my art.
One of the questions that we had was how teaching and art would influence each other, but I think maybe now you just answered that because you said that some things may happen in the school and then influence your art, no?
Yeah, sometimes from your life come to art, things from art go out to your life. And I work with the students, art students, and they are really willing to know about the new computer medium, 3D animation, 3D video games, and it's a good way to translate to them my experience in both ways. And when you work alone in your studio and you know about the renders and technical things about 3D studio, you cannot share that with anyone because people around you are not interested in this stuff. It's very lonely way to work. I have some friends that are artists, but they don't do anything with 3D studio. And like, it's like the way to share this with my students is a way to communicate and to expand and express myself.
Exactly.
So your first series of work that you sent us used games and game pieces as your subject material in the series, like puzzle pieces or billiards, but with elements of surrealism. Mm-hmm. We'll put a couple of those pieces up on the screen, but could you tell us about this artwork and why you chose games as your subject matter?
Okay, yes, I after the deja vu, after the this exhibition, I was asked to prepare another individual exhibition in Calahorra. So I decided to enter in some very complicated geometries. You know what I mean? I had to work with basic geometry because it was in the 28, something like that. And it took a lot of time to make a render. So I decided to play with things that are simple in the geometry way, like pieces of the cube or the cards are planes, are the domino pieces are like cylinders, with this kind of stuff, you know. So I decided to work with this because of the geometry was simple, because for me it was to play with this, play with the computer, play with the exhibition, play with the ideas, and I decided to start with this.
That brings us to the next question, because before you did 3D, you also did like traditional other types of art, inks and pencils and watercolor and stuff like this. Do you still do this, or do you just completely gone for the 3D now?
No. A traditional art is like I do, because I can take the notebook and I can draw every place, traveling and feminist drawing, and it's quicker and it's, do you understand? I always draw, and the draw is for me is the base for everything. When I draw, I develop the ideas quickly. Sometimes the ideas go to nowhere, sometimes yes, sometimes to retake, and it's like the way to put everything out quickly is like the base of everything.
Yeah, but they complement each other.
Yes.
So your second series of work, well, toy characters, this seems to be carrying on a similar theme of games from your first series. And it's still very surreal, but adds a more personal or human element by including figures in your work. We'll put up a couple images to show. Could you go into more details about this? Hmm.
Okay, after juegos, I was asked to make another exhibition, and I could see that I could dominate in some kind the techniques with the computer, a better processor with more RAM, a graphic tiger better. So I decided to get more involved in this kind of 3D stuff. So I decided to do at the same time something more complicated with the geometry. So make more advanced geometries. And I always play with, when I was a child, I loved work with clicks and to invent histories, situations with the clicks and to retake that kind of play. Take the clicks and put it in a situation and play with them. Because for me, art is like place to experiment, play with ideas, play with things, with materials, with elements, and we'll see what happens later.
Brian and I were talking to each other, and we said that we really liked clicks, because when you look at it like quickly, it looks very, very simple. But when you start looking at it, you discover all the nice ideas and all the, you know, all the, it's like a deeper level, you know, and it's really nice. So we like it. Nice.
Oh, thank you.
So your third series of work that you sent to us take on pop culture, like the Stormtrooper helmets and famous art, like Johannes Vermeer painting Girl with a Pearl Earring, or Andy Warhol's painting the Campbell's Soup Cans. We'll put a couple images up on the screen for our viewers. But could you tell us a bit about this series?
Okay. This is the technique again evolved. I bought a new computer because in between series years passed, so I had to actualize with the computer, advancing technically speaking pictures. So in this case, I add the ZBrush application. Is another application. The process is you work with 3D Studio is very geometrical 3D Studio, but you take 3D Studio and you put the geometry and you import the geometry in ZBrush, and in ZBrush you can model like a virtual clay. It's like like with clay, you draw with the brushes the geometry that you did in the application. So it's another step, technically speaking. I took some courses in Madrid with ZBrush and I like it a lot. It was another step up in the technique. So I don't know why I was working with the students, with Egypt, with the Renaissance, with the pop art. So I like it to take further away these ideas and to translate to the present and to connect the tradition, the historical tradition, the high art with the popular culture.
All right, taking art into NFTs on Cardano. Did you know that you can actually do this right now with the native asset functionality? So you don't need to wait for Gogen. There are actually a few different platforms that have NFT makers you could do this yourself with, like nftmaker.io or metromermaids.com/mint. Or you could even team up with a group that works with you to release NFT art, like maddenart.io or cnft.io.
I am very, very new with this. Mm-hmm. I discovered Cardano 3 weeks ago, 4 weeks ago. I was in Bitcoin, and I decided to buy some Ether. And when I was Ether, I discovered Cardano. I fall in love with Cardano. I listened to the Charles Hawkinson about the improvements relationship with Ethereum, and I say this is what I look in as an investor in world. But I realized that it's a good way to put in move my art again. So I am researching and I have to learn a lot about it in NFTs. Yeah. And I have to mm-hmm. I open to everything. I have to explore.
Did you already have any ideas about what you want to do with your images? Because I mean, with NFTs you can do anything, no, Brian? You can yeah. make any kind of, you can make a move or make sounds, or you can completely change everything.
Yes. Yeah, and they are like, you can make collisions. I've seen ideas. For instance, I make collisions with the same pictures and making small variations. That's an idea. Another idea is to put these are 3D pictures, so you can put move lights, move pictures inside, make a little like animated GIF. I think there are a lot of possibilities with this. I have to explore more, but I think it's very, very interesting. I'm very interested in NFTs. But I don't know how to do them and how to when to exhibit them. I have to learn this.
We know a little bit about Cardano, so we can give you a lot of ideas and tips. You know, you can do it yourself, or you can get other people to do it. So we can put you in touch, you know, with the right people. So I mean, we're looking forward to seeing your arts as NFTs on different platforms. Last thing, where can people find you? What are your website and your social media link, Facebook? Where can we find you?
I have some works in Flecha. Flecha is a virtual gallery. Bueno, it's a real gallery and it has a virtual site. They exhibit in Madrid. At the same time as Arco, you know, the Arco is the contemporary fair of art, and they do Flecha. And Flecha, I have in fact, I don't know what happens with the colors are not very, very good in the page. And I have some material also exhibit in Galería Murillo in Oviedo. I work with these galleries.
Okay, so people can also go and physically see your artworks, not only online.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Mm-hmm.
Cool. Brian, do you have any last message for Emilio?
I'm just excited to see what you do next. I mean, you seem to be a step of technology and improving your artwork. So I'm really excited to see what you're doing next with Cardano. And
thank you.
Yes, me too. And Emilio, you're in Spain, so maybe you'll have a chance to come down to Barcelona and make some art in the hotel.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I would like to participate.
Yeah, that'd be great. Mm-hmm. All right, guys. Thanks for the podcast.
Thank you, everybody,
okay,
for having me here.
Bye, Emilio.